Hello everyone, welcome to IndySAC. Today we are going to correctly connect a pressure transmitter with any PLC. Let us begin. First we will see the PLC manuals, to be able to compare their connections. We have the analog module of a Mitsubishi PLC. In its connections, we can use inputs voltage or current. At the terminals we have two positive signals V+4 voltage and I+4 current. The BI- is the negative of the signal. Now the analog module of the Delta PLC. In the same way in its connections. We have the current or voltage signals, V+ and I+, and the negative signal COM. In the analog module of the Siemens PLC, in its connections, we only have two signals, positive and negative. In this case, the positive can receive the voltage or current signal. Ready. This is the pressure transmitter that we will use. Let's open it. We have three signals. If the transmitter is current, only one and two are used. One is the positive, two is the signal. If the transmitter is a voltage transmitter, one, two and three are used. One is the positive, two is the GND. 3 is the signal. Well, now we are going to connect the pressure transmitter to the Siemens S7-1200 PLC. This PLC has built-in analog inputs and outputs, but their inputs can only receive a voltage signal from 0 to 10 volts. We begin to join the negative of the input, the 3M, to the PLC source, to the negative, M. We will connect a current pressure transmitter, 4 to 20 milliamps. In this case, to convert the current into a voltage of 0 to 10 volts, we use a 500 ohm resistor. We connect it to signal 0. We join the free end of the resistance to the negative of the source. Now we use the positive of the transmitter, it will be a red wire. We connect it to the L+. We connect the transmitter signal to signal 0 of the PLC. We connect alternating voltage to the PLC. And we are going to program the PLC. We are in TA portal. We select the PLC. Properties. In general. We look for the analog signals. We have it. Analog input, it is connected to channel 0, the address we will use will be IW64. Which receives the signal 0 to 10 volts. Now in programming we need to scale the signal in units of pressure, in this case pound per square inch. Or known as PSI. We use the norm and scale block. In the norm block we convert INT data to real. In min we put 0. In value the address, IW64. At max, 27648, which is equivalent to 10 volts. In out we use an MD0 memory. In the scale block, we convert real data to real. The pressure transmitter has a capacity of 0 to 60 PSI. We place that information in the PLC. We set it to a minimum of 0. In value the memory MD0. At max 60 PSI. Finally, add out an MD4 memory. We upload the programming to the PLC. Ready now if we can read the pressure from the transmitter. We will connect a small tube to the transmitter. We enter air to be able to read the pressure. We observe that in the MD4 memory, the pressure is read in PSI. Ready. Now we will make the connection for a voltage pressure transmitter, from 0 to 10 volts. In this case, three cables are used. We have the positive, red cable to the positive, L+, the GND, black wire, connected to the 3M, and the signal, blue wire, connected directly to signal 0. We enter air to be able to read the pressure. We observe that in the MD4 memory, the pressure is read in PSI. Well, now we will see the pressure transmitter with the PLC in a water pump application. The following system has two frequency drive. Also a solenoid valve that allows the passage of water. Two water pumps. The pressure and a pressure reader. We observe the connection of the pressure transmitter. Connected to the PLC, it is a current transmitter, since it uses two cables in addition to the resistance. In the PLC, three outputs are being used. Q0.0 is frequency drive 1, Q0.1 is frequency drive 2, and Q0.2 is the solenoid valve. Each drive is connected to its digital inputs, which allows the water pump to operate. The PLC is in stop, I will put it in run. Turn on output Q0.2 and Q0.0. We see that the pressure begins to rise to 40 PSI, and frequency drive 1 turns off. Let's open the tap halfway. The pressure begins to drop. When it is less than 30 PSI, activate frequency drive 1. The pressure rises until it exceeds 40 PSI. And frequency drive 1 turns off. We turn off the tap, and the pressure stops dropping. Now we open the tap completely. The pressure goes down. It reaches less than 30 PSI, activates frequency drive 1. The pressure goes up. We see that the pressure needs help to exceed 40 PSI, so frequency drive 2 is activated. Now it does exceed 40 PSI. The frequency drives are turned off. We turn off the tap, and the pressure stops dropping. Well, I hope you liked the video, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and leave your like. Thanks for watching, until next time.